Hi guys, I just thought I'd share my experiences with making my own homemade Python for doing the water changes. I tried a few things out and kind of come up with what I think is a pretty decent solution which works for me. So I was going to put some pictures up, but I thought rather than doing that I'll just do a quick video because it's probably a bit easier. So to start with, I went for the cheap waterbed water drain, which you can get from eBay for something like 4 or 5 quid. There's a couple of bad reviews on it about water coming out, but essentially what you have to do is make sure that you tighten up the internal join on the top, basically screws out, and that's where I got a few leaks from to start with. But as soon as that was tightened up properly, then it's been working perfectly, no leaks from it whatsoever. The only thing I've upgraded on that was just to attach to my mixer tap. It comes with a white plastic one, but I upgraded to a metal one. It was a few quid, but just seems to be a lot better. But the white one does work perfectly, to be honest. Next thing that I bought was a gravel cleaner. Now the ones which come with the Python are quite small, and then you can buy an upgrade to a larger one. So the small one was just absolute waste of time for me. The gravel was just getting sucked straight up it and getting pulled out. So I bought one which was above the water level of my tank. Now this is it in my tank, and the reason I like it so tall is when you are sucking the gravel out to clean it, the gravel's only coming up to about here mostly, and then the rest of it is just a clear water channeling which takes all the rubbish out, but lets your gravel all drop back in. So much better than the small one which I had, which was a third of the size. Next part of it I bought was, well, I already had the hose pipe, so obviously run from the tap. So this part connects to the tap, to the waterbed changer. So that part connects to the tap. It's to the tap. The water drains out of here, and you twist this on or off to create either a vacuum or flow the water back through the hose pipe into the tank. And then the third part of the water drain system which I created was probably a bit of an extra, and you can buy the extra for the Python, but it's a hook to go over the tank. So I made this with several bits of pipe. So you've got a normal hose connection on the end. It's one-handed. Normal hose connection on the end. And then using half inch pipe, just pieced it together to go up over the tank and then back in. So everything is glued apart from this end piece which pops out, and then depending on the level of water change that I want to do, I've got different length pipes, so I can just pop the end off, a longer pipe in, piece on the end, and then I can drain as much or as little of the water as I like. The reason I went for a T piece on the end is for when I'm filling up, that the water is, rather than going straight down, it's going to go out to the sides, save disturbing the gravel. And then one thing I did add extra in is a thermometer, so I can see the temperature of the water as it goes into the tank. And all it did is, for this particular one, I drilled a 5mm hole into the pipe, put the temperature sensor in, used the same glue, the PVC pipe glue around it, and that's going to give me the temperature of the water as it goes into the tank, so I can avoid any scalding of the fish. The reason I did it in that part of the pipe rather than this part, which is inside the tank, is because this pipe is essentially going to be filled with water, however fast the flow is. So whatever the temperature probe picks up is going to be fully submerged water, whereas this side, which I was initially going to do because of the chance of it popping out, I went against it because there's not going to be that much pressure going into the tank, and at that point the water's going to have gone up and over the curve, and it's not, the probe's not necessarily going to be submerged in water, it's going to be water and air in there. So I thought this was the better place for the temperature probe. So I'll just hook over the top of the tank, and then the pipe will connect to it, to the water change tap, or to the drainage hose, and see, for normal water changes I can just use the hook. If I want to do a gravel clean, then I can use the gravel cleaner. Obviously, now the connections were the biggest pain in the neck for me, and I went for these ones, which are a little bit more expensive than others I've found, because they are totally watertight. Now, I did buy some of these, and I've had other ones similar to this in the past, and they just leak water everywhere. They're not the best, and these ones are going back to where I bought them from. In the garden is fine, I think, but when you're trying to do it in your living room, you don't want water leaking everywhere. Certainly not as I'm doing over the baby's toys. So I went for these ones. Essentially, slot in, and then you twist, and then that is locked, and I've tested it out and it's 100% waterproof. And then to undo the other way, I can do that one-handed. All it is just a rubber seal on both sides. They're identical both sides, but three are the same. See, one on the hose pipe that goes to the tank, one on the hook, and then one on the gravel cleaner, and I can just interchange those as I need. So it enables me to do the water change, keep an eye on the temperature of the water going into the tank, and it worked perfectly. It really speeds it up. The only issue they had with these connectors, with this particular hose, the reinforced hose, just regular garden hose, is it's very tight. I really struggled to get that connector on. The only way I managed to do it was to heat it up in front of an electric heater so it went quite soft, and then I had to push it over a tube that you'd get on a silicon pipe or like silicon sealer. The tube narrows down, push it over that to stretch it out, leave it to cool, and then as soon as it cooled, then to push it over as far as I could over the connector, and then just stick a pipe clamp on there just to hold it. Again, there's not a massive amount of pressure going through these things, but I can't pull those together now that it's on. I did try hot water and pushing it on, but it's one of those that as soon as it's soft, it just bends and flexes and you're trying to push it on, and then it's too hard to push on when it's not soft. So that was the best solution I found. If you didn't have reinforced hose and it's just regular clear hose, I think it had just pushed straight on, no problem. But this is the hose I had at the time, and it's the hose I've been using for a while now. So yeah, it works perfectly, and the only thing that I would possibly change, and I may change in the future, is stick another hard piece of pipe in this section here, just after the portion that attaches to the tap. A solid piece of pipe in it, and stick another temperature probe in there, just so I can adjust the temperature easily.